Good Friday, everybody. Jewel here with you with your tropical update at the J7409 Weather Channel. Hey, thanks so much for checking things out with me today. I appreciate it. This is the early morning forecast. It should not change much, but I will try to have you an afternoon update because why? AL92, this little system right here. It's a small but concentrated area of showers and thunderstorms. Now, it is going to persist with an area of low pressure. It's around 225 miles east of Jacksonville, Florida. Now, however, it is unclear if the system possesses a well-defined surface circulation. And we're going to check all that in the later part of this video, so stick around for it. Now, the environmental conditions remain marginally conducive for some additional development, and this system could become a short-lived tropical depression as the low moves west-northwestward around 10 to 15 miles per hour. The system is expected to approach the northeast coast of Florida or Georgia coast later today. And interest there should monitor the progress of the system. And we do have an Air Force Reserve aircraft scheduled to investigate the system later this morning if necessary. It has a 50% chance of forming 2 days, 7 days. Well, the 7 days, don't worry about it because it's going to come inland before then. But it does have a 50% chance of forming into a tropical depression, not a tropical storm, but some real rainy and wind gusty winds. Not too bad, nothing you can't handle, but it's going to be nasty weather, more or less, for this area. Now we have disturbance number two that popped up yesterday, and it's still a broad area of low pressure. Looks like it's going to form over the southeastern Mexico and northern Central America area later today. Environmental conditions appear conducive for gradual development after this system moves over the Bay of Campeche tomorrow, Saturday, and a tropical depression could form over the southwestern Gulf of Mexico this weekend. And it's moving very slow west-northwestward or northwestward, and it's looking like 2 days, 40% chance, 7 days, 60% chance of forming. One thing, please never forget, remember, this can always change, and it can change very fastly. That's why for AL92, disturbance number one, we're tracking it on the TBCN track right here. This is my favorite model that tracks storm, folks. And we'll check them all out here, but this is one of my favorites that I usually go by for myself, and I try to refer it over to you guys. Looking like it's going to take it right in here just above Jacksonville and below Savannah. That's what it looks like. Let's see if we can make this just a tad bigger. See if there's any towns and stuff around Brunswick. That's what it's looking like. Brunswick right in here. Then moving it up Statesboro through South Carolina. Moving it right on across here in North Carolina. And right off my Outer Banks coast, just a little bit south of Nag's Head. That's what the TVCN model looks like, okay? But we have other models, so let's bring this back down just a little bit, as we can see right here. And you see it's around 225 miles, something like that, off the coast. Right in here, right now, Jacksonville as it is, but we'll take that model off. We'll put on all of the early models and where they're all together, just about the same area as you can see. TVCN has it pushing in a little bit further north than the rest of them, but we better watch it. You know, we might get some rain. Yeah, and boy, do we need it where I live. I mean, the corn crops are looking pitiful. And all the other crops are looking pitiful. This is the early model where it may go off more or less in the same direction, moving off the coast of North Carolina, coming in here down around just below south of Savannah, around the other area, Brunswick right in here. Let's take this off, put on all the late models. And the late models have it actually going where most of them are clustered together right here, just about in the very same area, okay? And then when it does hit land, it kind of jogs around some. You got some going off the coast down here in South Carolina, south of Myrtle Beach, and then you got some up here in the regular place where the TVCN model has it. So we're just going to have to watch and make sure that you're ready, because if this thing were to spin up, I don't think it's going to. I could be wrong. I don't think it's going to, though. But it could, because that's what they do these days. You guys know when they get to the close, they spin up. I don't think this one's going to have time enough to spin up to a very big storm. It could be a tropical depression. And who knows, it could be a tropical storm, but I think it does have a chance of becoming a tropical depression, but not a tropical storm at this time. Now, this updated Euro model, okay? And we see what disturbance number two is looking like. Those went into piling. This was at 6 a.m. this morning. This has a little curvature up here for disturbance number one moving into the water. It's not formed yet, though. So let's move it up to around 4 p.m. for this afternoon. See what it may look like. Looks like it's still trying to form some, but not quite. It's trying to get a little vorticity circulation down here, but it's still not getting it like it should. But it will be bringing rain into the coast of and areas of South Carolina, Georgia, and northern Florida by 4 p.m. this afternoon. Maybe a little bit even before. We'll move it up, say, early Saturday morning around 1 a.m. and see what it looks like at that time. Well, by one formed, it's what hit land has dissipated just into very, very winds, maybe around 5 to 10, maybe 12 mile an hour sustained winds. It's still out here, hadn't moved all the way around. But you know what this little sucker's going to do? As time goes by, it's going to move, and it's going to move off our coast like the TVCN model had it going. And then it might form out here. But it shouldn't bother us. But remember, yesterday I told you, down around Puerto Rico, the Northern Island Chain, Dominican Republic, you guys might be getting something. Well, let's come up to, say, Monday morning early. See what happens then. We've got another wave coming off of Africa, coming over here for the islands. And if you notice, by Monday, over here on the Euro model, this is only the Euro model showing this right now, okay? But that's what I think is going to happen. This disturbance should be getting right to dissipate altogether. Now, it may not. You know me, I don't ever tell you what's really going to happen. I'm not quite sure on this, but I think it's going to be okay for the Gulf Coast states with disturbance number. You can see this is Monday at 4 a.m. over here. This has gone off the coast, and look at all the stuff it's getting triangulated in this big high pressure. As long as this high pressure is out here, folks, we are going to have storms that make up in the Gulf, down in the Caribbean, over here on the coastline. That's what happened. But now back to here. Let's get right here. This is at 4 a.m. When I said something might try to pop up on Monday for you guys, somewhere around this area, right up in here. Well, we're up to 7 a.m. now, and nothing's still happening. We're up to 8. Nothing's still really happening. When we get to Monday afternoon, this coming Monday, the 24th, around 1 p.m., we got all of this wind that's trying to do something. Around Dominican Republic, around the Northern Island Chain, it will affect Puerto Rico, maybe some of Jamaica too as we go on in time. Let's go up now to 8 p.m. Monday night. These are trying to get some vorticity. Not going to be gusty around these areas in the island chain. Not too bad. Nothing you can handle. Probably in the 30s. We'll move up to Tuesday. Tuesday morning. See if it dissipates some. See what happens with it. All of the islands, and even the little ABC islands, are getting some wind gusts. Not too bad. Nothing you cannot handle. It's going to go over to Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic, and probably over to Jamaica. I will go up Tuesday afternoon, say around 1 p.m. I don't want to go much further because we all know how these things can change. Looking like nothing too bad by Tuesday afternoon, but we're going to watch this because it can blow up too. We're going to watch it, okay? Everybody else is looking okay in the Gulf at this time. Doesn't mean it'll stay that way, but it looks okay for now. And everything is staying offshore for the northern coastal sections of North Carolina and also Canada, just skimming by some of the areas up in Canada. Not really a big deal for anybody. This is what it looks like right now. When we go back today, say around 1 p.m., we need to pay attention, and I'm going to keep up on this for you. We do have this from AL92 and land sometime this afternoon, I think. Maybe early evening. Not too late at night. It should be late this afternoon or early evening. I'd say probably before 9 or 10 o'clock. The thing should be inland well. Maybe if not before then. But it could turn into a tropical depression. No doubt about it. You would get a few, some gusty winds enough to mess up some power lines at times, enough to knock down some tree limbs at times, things like that. So make sure you park your car somewhere that's not under a tree if you're in these areas, or put it in your garage. I don't think it'll turn into a tropical storm, but this crazy weather is, folks, anything is possible. But I do think it will maybe have a chance to become a tropical depression. So take care. Stay safe. I love you guys. Thank you for every single thing you do for me. I appreciate it very, very much. All of you guys that give me donations, I appreciate it. I appreciate you watching my videos and sharing my videos to help me keep people safe and aware of what's coming their way. So, with that said, have yourself a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. Thanks so much for watching.